Good day and welcome to the Christopher C. Kraft Jr. Mission Control Center in Houston, Texas, and the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team of flight controllers being led by Derek Hossman, who's the flight director in charge of the team, working closely with Dan Tiney, the astronaut who will be talking with the Expedition 29 crew aboard the International Space Station, are watching over the systems for the station and integrating activities with the crew. Commander Mike Fossum and flight engineers Satoshi Furukawa and Sergei Volkov are continuing their six-month expedition aboard the International Space Station. They're in a three-person crew mode as they await the upcoming launch on November 14th of NASA's Dan Burbank and Russia's Anatoly Ivanishin and Anton Shkaplerov, who will round out the Expedition 29 crew for a brief period. And then the three crew members who are on board about 6 days later after completing a handover will come back to Earth. And the next crew with NASA astronaut Dan Pettit will get ready to launch to the International Space Station in late December. All systems aboard the space station working very well today, and the crew has been up since approximately 1 a.m., their normal wake-up time, Central Time. They've been having a very busy day today with a number of different experiment activities. Mike Fossum has been focusing his experiment work with the Sphere satellites. That is a satellite, a constellation of three small cube-like satellites on board the International Space Station. SPEAR stands for Synchronized Position, Hold, Engage, Reorient, and Experimental Vehicles. And they're used to train and test systems, software systems that could provide for automated docking in the future, which could help with future human spaceflight. Satoshi Furukawa is meanwhile working on some hatch inspections in the U.S. segment of the space station. These hatches are inspected periodically, and the folks here on the ground in the operations support discipline are looking at maybe changing the frequency of this from every 90 days to every 180 days. But so he's taking a close look at all of the seals and hatches, and if there are any if there's any need doing some minor cleaning of those hatches. He's also photo documenting the condition of each of the hatches in preparation for reducing the frequency of that activity. Sergei Volkov, meanwhile, was working with one of the Russian experiments on board, the Uragan or Hurricane experiment, which is an Earth observation experiment looking at natural disasters on the Earth. It started back in the days of the Mir space station. That's related to the overall crew Earth observation activities that are going on board the space station. Crew has a number of targets today. We do have some video that was recorded in time-lapse from a camera positioned in the cupola module. This shows the Aurora Australis, a very spectacular view as the space station orbited overhead. It was taken by the Expedition 28 crew members before they departed. That was Ron Garin, Alexander Samokutyayev, and Andrei Borisenko. Some additional Earth views associated with the Southern Lights also recorded. Today's targets for Earth observations included some various locations around the world, Luanda, Angola, Johannesburg, South Africa, and Tropical Storm Philippe were among the targets for the space station crew today with Earth observations. In addition, the crew, of course, will get its normal complement of exercise on board the International Space Station, taking about 2 to 2.5 hours to exercise. And they're also going through the remaining food and supply stores from 42 Progress, the most recently arrived Progress to the International Space Station, to look for anything they want to keep or also dispose of the next time a Progress departs. Commander Mike Fossum called down just a little bit ago with surprise and a lot of happiness that he had discovered some espresso coffee in those 42 Progress stores that were planned for use by a previous crew but went unused, and so he's going to take advantage of that espresso coffee a little bit later in his day. So the International Space Station currently tracking from southwest and northeast over the Pacific off the coast of Japan, headed for a landfall in the Pacific Northwest of the United States. This is Mission Control Houston.